Exporting your project is the last step before having your latest creation cemented into a final video file. Unless you forgot to toggle off that one track, in which case you now have to export final underscore final. But today we're going to be taking a look at a few ways to export your final project, whether that be for review, web upload, collaborations, or socials. Also, never name your project final. I was joking, although I've done it a lot. But don't do it. To start, let's open our export panel. There's a few ways that you can do this. First, make sure your sequence is selected. Go to File, Export, and tap Media. You can also use the shortcut Control-M if you're on Windows or Command-M if you're on a Mac, or click Export in the top left corner here. But now that you're here, you'll be presented with a few options like what you want your file name to be, where you want your exported file to be located, the option to use built-in or your own pre-made presets, and the format of your file. For the presets, you can choose to scroll down and tick more presets. Here, you'll have many pre-made presets from Adobe to make exporting as easy as possible. So I can look up something like Facebook or YouTube and choose one of these presets. Down here in your video settings, you can match your sequence settings by tapping the Match Source button or clicking the checkbox. But let's say you want to send over a lower resolution file for review. You can unclick the checkbox next to frame size and lower to your desired resolution. If you're uploading a 9x16 video on social media, just make sure your sequence dimensions are in 9x16 aspect ratio and double check that you have Match Source ticked for frame size. If you hit the More box, you'll find more advanced settings. Rendering at max depth will ensure that your exported file has the highest amount of color information that your selected format will allow. This can help avoid banding if you have gradients or a lot of detailed color choices in your project. Right below it, you'll find the Use Maximum Render Quality, which will maximize the quality of your clips to its full potential. This works especially well when you have any clips that were scaled up. However, having this option ticked will result in longer encode times and will require a good amount of RAM. Chances are you aren't likely to tick Render Alpha Channel only unless you are doing specific VFX work that require a matte export, but it's always nice to have that option. Continuing further down, you also have bitrate settings. In simplest terms, the lower the bitrate number, the less information that each pixel will have, therefore a lower resolution file. Higher bitrates means more information, which means
higher resolution!
Proud of you. Think of when you're watching something on streaming and the internet speed throttles. At that point, your image degrades because you're being fed a lower bitrate that works with lower internet speeds. For encoding settings, you have CBR, which stands for constant bitrate, and VBR, which stands for variable bitrate. A constant bitrate will have what the name implies, a more consistent bitrate and image quality with faster encodes. A variable bitrate will have longer encode times, but will produce a higher quality result. There's no true right answer to what's better. If you're exporting a file and you plan to play straight from your device, then CBR will probably be better since it's easier to load and play. For web uploads, VBR could be best since it's a higher quality and can help against noticeable compression on your videos. Continuing down, we have all your audio settings, which I usually leave untouched. The same applies for multiplexer. If you want to burn captions into your file, simply tick on the captions box and change your export options to burn captions into video. Down in effects, you have the option to burn a LUT in over your entire file. Use image overlay, which is how you would burn in your logo or any visual image onto the entirety of the video, text overlay, which you can use to mark what version your export is on to avoid any mix-ups, or timecode overlay, which is useful when sending your video off to another collaborator since it allows for frame-specific notes. Then wrapping up with metadata and general, I normally never touch these, but hey, they're there, and I appreciate it. To the left of these settings, you have the ability to upload your file to any of these social media platforms as soon as your render is complete. This can be incredibly useful in a situation where you have to leave your computer, but you're wanting to upload right away. Simply tick the platform of your choice, sign into your account, and fill out the video information like you normally would. You even have the option to set your custom thumbnails here. Knowing all these settings is one thing, but the key is choosing the right format package for your project. If you're looking to have a small file size with the highest video quality possible, then your best bet is H.265. This is pretty much the industry standard since you're getting the best of both worlds, high quality and low sizes. And I would say this is probably the best format for most scenarios, including social media. For those who don't care about file size and want the maximum amount of quality in their file, QuickTime with ProRes codec is going to be your best option. This is great when you want your footage to remain as lossless as possible. available. This option can also be great for uploading to YouTube when you want to make up for the compression that YouTube adds to their videos. It is overkill for your standard video, but for those higher-end projects that you're especially proud of, ProRes is the way to go. Finally, there's miscellaneous formats like JPEG, PNG, and TIFF if you want Premiere to export every frame individually if you're in need of some kind of image sequence. Or maybe you're looking to only export the audio track. Then you have a few choices like MP3 or WAV. Or let's say you have a project that needs a digital cinema package, also known as a DCP file for film festivals or theatrical screenings. Then you can change the format to Raptor DCP. Just keep in mind that you only have these three options for your video dimensions. So if you need to, you can always create a new sequence, then pop in your final edit sequence and scale to fit. Once you have your format and settings ready, make sure that your range is set how you want it, either the entire project or a selected range. Then you can either export right from here or click Send to Media Encoder, which will also allow you to set up a queue of videos to export if needed. But there you have it, the basics of everything you need to know to export your project. As always, if you have something that you would like to see us cover, feel free to drop us a comment below. And subscribe to the channel for more tutorials and updates like this one, because giraffes are 30 times more likely to get hit by lightning than people. That's actually true.